What is findability? Findability refers to how easily a piece of information can be found. If information isn't findable, it's not usable. Does your bookshelf look like this? I'm guessing not. My bookshelf is a jumble of colors, shapes, sizes, and piles. But I pretty much know what I have, so if I need to find a particular piece of information in a book, it usually doesn't take me too long to find it. But what about in a library? It's filled with pieces of information printed on the pages of books, millions of pages. How can we find the right book, let alone the right page, to get what we need? It wouldn't work if we kept the library the way that I keep my bookshelf at home, and it probably wouldn't work if we organized the shelves by color either. That would be bad findability. So how do we make things findable? Let's think for a minute about what you would do if you were going to open a music store. You would probably start by labeling your bins by genre, pop, classical, jazz, and so on. You could get as specific as you wanted, and split those into subgenres if you thought your customers would be knowledgeable enough to appreciate the fine distinctions. But you'd still have a disorganized pile in each bin. Eventually, you'd need to impose an arbitrary order within your categories, and it would probably be alphabetical order by the artist's name. What I mean by that being arbitrary is that there's no inherent property of M that makes it naturally precede N. It's just that we all agree that that's the order we think of the letters in. Libraries tend to follow this principle. First we group things into categories, then we organize within the categories using an arbitrary system like the alphabet. You can probably think of some other things we encounter in our day-to-day lives that are organized in the same way. In our library, the books are organized by subject according to a complex system created for the Library of Congress. That is, literally, the library in Washington, D.C. that the U.S. Congress uses when they need to do research, and which you can see a picture of here. Their system groups books by subject and assigns a code to each book. That code is the call number on the spine, and it tells the library staff where to put the book away and the patron where to find it again. On the other hand, even after centuries of refinement, it still takes many hours of labor each day to maintain all the library materials in their right places. And we hear plenty of complaints that it's hard to find things in the library from people who can't get the hang of the system. Is the digital revolution going to completely change all that? It's true that going digital is a fantastic opportunity to rethink how we organize, find, and use information. But take a look at this map of the internet. The web is just the opposite of a library. The information on the web has no organization, no system, no categories, just trillions of words connected by links. Does that make information more or less findable? Digital information isn't a physical thing. It can be in many places at the same time, unlike a book, which can only be in one place at a time. The new paradigm is a world without the constraints of shelves or categories or fixed forms. This means that it's up to every user to go fishing in this disorganized sea of information. Metadata helps us navigate all this information. Meta means about. So metadata is data about data, or information about information. For example, do your parents or grandparents have a bunch of old photos in a box somewhere? If you open up the box by yourself, you might just find snapshots of people in old-fashioned clothes. It would be a lot more interesting to be with someone who can tell you about the photos. Who's in them, how they're related to you, when they were taken, what was going on. That's the metadata. How does this work when it comes to searching? Assigning metadata to a piece of information online is like making a place where you've put it away, where you know you'll be able to find it again. People often call this tagging, attaching a little label to information that describes what it's about. Assigning metadata to a piece of information online increases its findability. Some info on the web has some metadata. It really varies. But all of the information in the library has metadata. That's how librarians put things away on the shelf, in the catalog, and in our databases. This is one reason why search strategies that work really well with Google sometimes fall flat with library search tools. The thing about findability is that it's not just about the information. It has to do with the user, too. You. The more you learn about information in general, the easier it will be to find the specific information you need. whether it's in the library or on the web.